Before wrapping up, there are some misconceptions and myths surrounding poison oak and ivy that you may have heard of or asked about. For instance, can eating the poison ivy leaf make me immune? No. In fact, ingesting a poison plant leaf could make you very ill, so don't even try it. Can I catch the rash from someone else? Generally speaking, the answer is no. The urushiol must get on your skin either through direct contact with the plants themselves or indirect contact with tools, equipment, clothing, or even pets that have the poison oil on them. Can bleach remove the urushiol? No. Some people try bleach or other home remedies that can cause damage to the skin and possibly spread the urushiol to other areas of the skin or make the allergic reaction even more serious. Only use approved products for blocking, removing urushiol, or treating the rash. In serious cases, medical attention may be required, so follow a doctor's recommendations closely. Do oozing blisters cause the rash to spread? No. The liquid coming out of the blisters of an advanced case of poison oak or ivy is the immune system's response to the rash. If the rash appears to be spreading, this is generally due to the urushiol being self-spread through scratching or clothing that still has the poison plant oil on it. We've talked about identifying what poison oak, ivy, and sumac look like and where they grow, so you can avoid direct contact whenever possible. We've also learned why urushiol is such a menace to your skin, how to block it or remove it, and how to prevent a rash from starting in the first place. And finally, we've looked at ways to treat a poison plant rash once it's started. We've given you some helpful steps you can take right now to avoid the itchy rash from poison oak, ivy, and sumac completely. For more information, plant identification guides, posters, or samples, contact Tech Laboratories at 1-800-ITCHING or 1-800-ITCHING.com.